picture this. You're a young actor rehearsing on the stage of the Breitenbach Theatre in Pretoria. The night before your big performance, you're fixated over the lines you'll be acting out. But suddenly, you're distracted by the sounds of feet dragging, and the hair on your arms start to rise. Suddenly, a spectre in the form of a woman dressed in white appears in front of you from the dressing room. She asks you, "Where are my children?"
En dan in die ochtend, vroeg. Ik is niet zo snel, want hij ligt hier. Het is om 7 uur, 6 uur, is ik al hier zo. Jij loopt hier zo en dan is het donker. Jij kan niet hand voor je ogen zien. En als je half part daar is, dan komt zij uit die dressingroom. En dan zegt ze van mij, Jan, waar is mijn kennis? Dat is kering hoor. Ik zei, nee, ik weet niet, maar wat is jouw kennis dan al? En zijn nooit voor mij gezien. Nooit.
Dat was de voice of oom Jan van den Brink. He used to work for the Breitenbach Theatre. Worked for them for over 20 years as prop designer for aspiring theatre students. He's an elderly man with thin brim glasses, gentle and quite friendly. He's also Dutch and can't really speak English very well. The female ghost that Oom Jan mentioned is Hedda. She was a nurse when the theatre was still a hospital during the flu epidemic that broke out after the First World War. Oom Jan describes her as a beautiful woman, regularly mentioning how striking her beauty is, appearing to be quite taken by her.
En wat voor mij gelijk het, was het een bij aantrekkelijke vrouw. Mooi figuur, al had zij die neusdusse pak aan gehad. Nee, dat was een bij aangename dame. Ik meen die stem, laat ik me niet verkeerd uitdrukken. Ja, dit was... Dat preken was een keer een rechter was. Dan kom je, als je dan daar zo loopt, dan kom je haar eigenlijk op de vlees.
Oom Jan isn't the only person who's seen her. Students he's worked with have even run away after laying their eyes upon Hedda. He spoke about how students didn't even want to stay late at the theater in fear of Hedda.
Elke ochtend en vertekend in die avond. Maar bij een keer in die avond, als ons hier studiedecor afbreekt, op een zaterdag, die studenten wil niet samen met mij weer zijn. Dan ga ik zo toe, zet al die lichten af en dan kom ik hier naartoe. En dan komt zij weer, Jan, waar is mijn kennis?
Oom Jan, on the other hand, seemed to be fond of her.
Die eerste paar keer was het, had ik hondervlees gekregen. Ja. Maar daarna raak je gewoon aan haar. Rechter waar, dan is het eindelijk. Als ze niet hier dan is, niet dan voel je ongemakkelijk. Waar is zij? Hoe komen ze niet hier zo niet?
The Breitenbach Theatre is quite dainty compared to the size of modern theaters. It's quaint, with the auditorium seats upholstered in velvet red. One can see from marks and scratches on the stage that the theatre's aged, with many stories to tell. But as said earlier, Breitenbach Theatre was not always what it is today. In fact, it has quite a colorful origin story. It started as a community hall for German natives to meet and host festivals. If you went outside the theater, you'd see an inscription, German Community Hall, but written in German. But during the flu epidemic in 1918, the hall soon was transformed into a hospital. That's the period when Hedda worked there as a nurse. She was said to look after the sick children. Under the current theater stage was the mortuary of the hospital. The small loading dock to remove the dead bodies still exists there.
Dat was een van de ziekte. Maar hier was bij lijken. En dan wordt die lijken worden dan afgedragen onderkant toe. En dan aan de buitenkant is een opening. Maar dat is een deur. En dan naar de rug wordt die lijken uitgedragen. Nee, dat was een lelijke ding hier zo. Baie lelijk, hoor. En hij had niet precies geweten wat de ziekte dit is. Maar dit was hiervoor, waar die woonstijlen allemaal staan. Dit was allemaal landen waar die beesten gelopen hadden. Allemaal, alles. En toen met die oorlog uitbrak, ik denk dat was de boerenoorlog, ik is niet zeker niet. toen heel die baaiziekte opdoen. Ja, dat was erg hoor. En die studenten en meewerkers, heel erg bang om onderkant toe te gaan. Als ik niet zou gaan, niet gaan heel erg niet onderkant toe.
After its time as a hospital, the building was used for a number of purposes. A school for needlework, an art studio. But in 1955, the National Theatre Organization acquired the building and it became a theatre. They renamed it Breitenbach in honour of Dr. Petrus Philippus Benjamin Breitenbach, fondly known as Oom Breki. He was kind of an activist for arts. Breitenbach Theatre became one of the best-known playhouses in the country in its heyday, but unfortunately lost its prominence when the State Theatre was opened in 1981. Technikon Pretoria, now known as Tshwane University of Technology, bought the theatre in 1984. Now it stands as a humble, somewhat grassroots auditorium for small production professionals and theatre students.
We were sitting in the auditorium and there was children running around laughing. Of the spirit box, we heard some strange voices.
That's Wynand van Sail of Phoenix Paranormal South Africa, which is basically a version of Ghost Hunters. They've visited many haunted places, including the Breitenbach Theatre. The theatre is dear to Wynand's heart as he used to attend to UT, and he assures that he's seen the ghosts.
The activity that we have found there, we did an investigation there, when was it? 2016 Halloween, exactly on the night of Halloween. We had a whole bunch of photographers there to come and assist us with the investigation. And we had camera bags being moved around.
Hedda wasn't the only paranormal entity they've encountered. Apparitions of children laughing, sounds of ghostly piano playing, and a new ghost that many have not heard of.
On a previous occasion, there was one of the actresses who... Then recently, she recently died, and after that, the investigation took place, and she was sort of trapped in one of the dressing rooms, and she was very, very aggressive, even attacked some of our investigators. Luckily, they didn't walk away with scratches, which is usually the case.
Aggressive ghosts that scratch? That's enough to give you the Mufasa shivers.
And then we also found that... down in the basement, underneath the stage, once again, with it's very dark, it's very damp, it's very claustrophobic down there. And that's usually when there's a few investigators who aren't as strong mentally, when you're feeling a little bit off, and so they do take advantage of that. So once they sense, or once that specific entity senses that, he or she will come out and sort of just turn the whole atmosphere upside down. And it's, that can get quite scary.
Another terrifying experience was when the lights above the stage suddenly fell. Oom Jan spoke about how the ropes attached to the lights looked like it was cut with a blade, but there was no explanation on who cut it.
3 meter, stormpipe, from the ene kant to the other kant, and they fell on the kant too. And I missed ook my net 2 studenten, meisjes. Ja, dat was scary. Rechtig.
So was dit iemand wat het actually gedaan of was dit iets wat jullie niet kan verduidelijken?
Nee, ons kan het niet verduidelijken. Ons heeft de politie hier gehad en de veiligheidsmensen van de Pretoria brandweer. Nee, ons heeft alles hier gehad. Want die pijp was gelaaid met lichten. Weer dat is aangeloed lichten. En dat is paaienwijgeld. Wat we hier was. Toen moest onze assurantie uitkrijgen om dit alles te vergoeden. Ja, nee, dat was. En die pijp is 50 mm stoompijp. En hij heeft gebuigd tussen vuren. Boven uit die dag.
Similar to the actors waiting backstage for the cue to go on and wow the audience, it seems that Hedda waits backstage too and sees Oom Jan as a cue to make herself visible to ask about the children that once frequented the venue in its previous life as a hospital. Losing children in an operating theater, Hedda now searches for them in a performing theater. But aside from the beautiful, delicate nurse, there appears to be more that maybe you should watch out for as these spirits also lurk behind the scenes of the theater, searching for victims in a weakened mindset that could see you being cut in both senses of the word. In the next and last episode, we go back to the city of Johannesburg, to the Sunnyside Park Hotel in Parktown, where the graceful apparition of the Duchess of Connaught appears.
This episode of Haunted was produced by Abigail Javier and Ahmed Kaji. It was narrated by Ayanda Nyati and edited by Peter Turon. To get a sneak peek of these ghostly places, visit ewn.co.za/haunted.